God's grace and peace to you, friends. Happy Pentecost. Pentecost, of course, is the day 50 days after Easter, where we celebrate the birth of the church, the pouring out of the Spirit upon all of God's creation, as we tell that story of the apostles once again on that Sunday. Today, it gives me great pleasure to let Mike King take over, for Mike to share a message with you that comes from his heart that he might share with you about how the Spirit works, about how we are the church together, about how it is to live in faith with one another. I'm excited for you to hear his words, and hopefully they will hold upon your heart and encourage you as they do for me. So let's worship together. Join me in our opening prayer. Triune God, make your presence known in this place through our worship, our prayer, and the reading of your word. We gather today as your body and your church in this world. Fill our outstretched hearts with your Spirit. Encircle us with love, helping us to know you in exciting and challenging new ways. Inspire us and empower us, we pray. Amen. Today's story, the story of Pentecost, comes from the second chapter of the book of Acts as the church is beginning. We're jumping back a little bit in the stories we've been telling to tell this story of the day the Spirit comes, as it were. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rushing of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each one of them. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak to each other in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living here in Jerusalem. And at the sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one of them heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they said, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we, each of us, in our own native language, can hear them and understand? Parthians and Medes and Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia and Judea and Asia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene and the visitors of Rome. It's all in our own language. We hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. all were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others, they sneered and they said, "They're just filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men dream dreams. And I will show portents in the heavens above and signs on the earth below. The sun shall darken, the moon turn red before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. And then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Here ends our reading.
Gentleness, blow through the wilderness. Now, I've heard stories of how others have explained and or talked about Pentecost. One was they started singing Happy Birthday to the church. And another thought popped into mind, too, from Alice in Wonderland. They had the tea party, and they're singing Happy Merry on Birthday to you and you and you. Yeah, it was a special, special birthday. And even though it was over 2,000 years ago, we are still all a part of it today. Pentecost Sunday celebrates the provision of God, fulfills the ancient prophecies of Scripture, and the promises of Jesus. Pentecost Sunday was a milestone in the redemptive history of the church, a supernatural inauguration of the worldwide mission of God in this world. Dr. Michael Milton from crossroad.com makes note, Pentecost is defined as the Christian festival celebrating the descent of the Holy Spirit on the disciples of Jesus after his ascension, held on the seventh Sunday after Easter. The day is also called Whit Sunday, the Jewish festival called Shavuot, the God-ordained celebration of first fruits. Now, Pentecost comes from the Greek word meaning 50 days, given for this ancient Jewish festival. Pentecost is the only one of the three great feasts not mentioned as a memorial of events in the history of the Jews. Still, such a significance has been found that in fact the law, the Ten Commandments, was given from Sinai on the 50th day after the deliverance from Egypt. In the Exodus, the people were offered to God as a living first fruits. At Sinai, their consecration to him as a nation was completed. Now, the importance of Pentecost to the church, Mr. Philip Nation states, is something that we need to walk through carefully and should not ignore. Because Pentecost was a Jewish celebration, our modern-day New Testament churches don't celebrate it in the same way as the Old Testament Hebrews did. Now, some use the familiar but muddled expression, the birthday of the church, to describe it. Pentecost is not really a birthday. The church, or the assembly of God and all of God's people, included the believers from Old Testament times also. He makes mention, he said, didn't Saint Stephen speak of the church in the wilderness when describing Moses and the people of God? The church in all of its different entities existed for years before. But this day was that moment in history after Christ had ascended, and he had promised, as told in the Gospels during his earthly ministry, that he would leave and that he would send the Comforter. He would send the Holy Spirit. And it was at that moment in Pentecost where the Spirit came and empowered the early believers. Now, Acts 2 begins, when the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven, there came a sound like a rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Can you imagine what that sounded like? A few weeks ago, we were invited to Florida for a few days to visit with Vicky's nephew and sit on the beach and soak up the sun. Well, burn and peel is probably more like it. But the sound of the ocean, the waves constantly rolling and crashing, it was loud. It reminded me of like Lake Michigan. When you get to those strong northeast winds and the waves are raging over the piers and the jetties, and the tremendous roar it made. Imagine that sound many times over, filling a room. It goes on, divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now this must have amazed the disciples themselves. Jesus' promise fulfilled, sending a comforter, the Holy Spirit, to help them perform the great commission that they had been charged with. Then too, think of those in the streets, hearing all this commotion, how they reacted. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem at the time. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one of them, speaking in the native language of each, amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all of these speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language?" Now, it seems like there must have been everybody from under the sun there at the time. The Parthians, the Medes, the Elamites, the residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, other Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They're just filled with new wine." Now, this reminds me of a story I remember hearing some time ago. It was back when people still liked Bill Cosby. And he had mentioned something in one of his routines, an exchange between a couple of, guys who like to drink wine, some winos. And I imagine it sounded a little something like this. "Habes, habes, 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 flammen, schaumi." "Flabisch, spricker, flammen, haben." No. Now, clearly, what the people heard was more than just this gibberish, and Peter was quick to clarify. Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I shall show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Dr. Milton reminds for us, Pentecost is the seventh Sunday after Easter, 50 days after that glorious resurrection, when the Spirit of the living God fell upon the disciples as promised, and they were empowered for a worldwide mission. And the breath of the Holy Spirit, which transformed them, which demonstrated Pentecost's intent by signs and wonders on that day, continues to blow, advancing the great commission of Jesus Christ through successive generations until he comes again. advancing the great commission of Jesus Christ until he comes again. Here is where our generation and those after us can pick up the baton and carry it to further God's mission, message in all the world. How can we be part of advancing the great commission of Jesus? Oh, a good place to start is light your pilot. Light your pilot and keep his spirit burning inside you. Light your pilot of prayer. Lift others and their needs to God. Light your pilot of service, being there for those in need of help, of a friend, of a listening ear. Light your pilot of compassion, caring and sharing your time and your faith and your tears, inviting others to come to church and be ready to greet and welcome the new faces that come through the doors at St. Paul's. Help make this church a place others would like to return to. For all are welcome. Light your pilot of love, volunteering at shelters, meal sites, or just simply holding a hand. Light your pilot with God's word in your life, your living and actions, your beliefs, share them with others. May his light shine through you and brighten someone's darkened world. May this Pentecost rekindle God's fire in our hearts, that we may be his hands and feet in service of his church, our community, and the whole world. May our own tongues of fire ever burn bright for him. Amen.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people's cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I made the stars and night, I made the darkness bright, who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will
my hands will say,
finest bread I will grow mine, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my arms.
Would you join me in prayer? God, we come together on this Pentecost day, this day where we think about flames and winds and your Spirit being poured out upon the people. While we celebrate this day so long ago, may it be true with us this day that your Spirit is poured out upon this place and that we are filled with your Spirit, that we might love more fully, that we may care for all of those in our path, and we might celebrate the good news of Jesus Christ by enacting his life and words and deeds and the way he lived and who he cared about with all we encounter. May the Spirit that surrounds each one of us give us strength and courage for the facing of these days. May the Spirit that surrounds us push us each further to be more and more filled with your goodness and light, that we may be your hands and feet in this world, God. We ask for all of those in our midst that the Spirit is more fully present among them, that they find comfort and peace. We would ask that all who are dealing with hard times find a moment of calm in the storm, that they are reminded of the goodness in this world and that your light shines in the darkness for them to see. Help us be angels to those who need us most, though they may be unaware. Help us to do these things not for our sake, but for the sake of your gospel, for the sake of your Son, and for the beloved kingdom he worked so hard to build. Let us be instruments in building that same beloved community, that we might all together live more fully in relationship with you, filled with grace and mercy, filled with the Spirit. We give thanks for all of these gifts, especially the Spirit, especially your Son. And so we raise our voices together and pray as he taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Oh.
With inspiration from the lyrics we shared, Spirit of God, fall fresh on us, overflow in this place, fill our hearts with love, let your love surround us all. Miracles can happen now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. He calls you by name, don't hesitate. Say, here I am, Lord, send me. Go and help advance the Great Commission of our Lord Jesus Christ in our generation and on to the next. His word lives on for all time. May God's grace, love, and peace shine on us all. And all God's children say amen. Amen. Go with God.